when you're ready. Okay, the first article is core value eating. I'm reeling in, everybody. Research shows clearly that diets do not work and can be harmful. If you believe it's hard to lose weight and keep it off because you lack something like discipline, willpower, common sense, your efforts come from shame. And I see it all the time. I'm bad. I beat myself up. Oh, I am so bad. And I say, are you really bad? Or did you just make some wrong choices? Go through a period where you might not have been on track. What we're trying to do here at Pray It Off is change our conditioned response from, instead of going bad day chips, bad day beer, bad day wine, stress, ice cream, we're trying to say bad day God, stress Jesus, help me Lord, replace it. Or bad day take a walk, bad day ride my bike, bad day get off my butt. That's how we're going to change our conditioned habits by saying my first response to stress is not going to be the chips. That's what's going to work. Also, there's an excellent article called The Carrot Train to Crazy Town, and it's from the Whole Nine Life website, which I got from the wonderful people and Aaron at Pine Grove. I love this article because it just shows you how people say, oh, you're eating carrots? Carrots have sugar. Or it's the same thing we said last week about banana. Oh, banana's not good for you. Never have I said to someone's log, you're eating too many carrots. Now, if you turn orange, you might be eating too many carrots. But what they're saying here is they're carrots. You know, no one is going to say, you know, oh, you had way too much broccoli, or what are you doing with all those cauliflowers? Eat, munch on veggies. Don't be crazy. If you want some grapes, eat some grapes. It's not that that's getting anyone in trouble, it's the pizza and wings. Also, the Whole 30 Daily, again, I got it from the Pine Grove and from Aaron, talks about cravings, talks about when you think you have to have something, are you hungry, angry, lonely, tired, halt. If you say to yourself, right now, I could go for some steamed fish and broccoli, and you want it, you might be hungry. You say, I'm really hungry because bring on the steamed fish and broccoli. Otherwise, if you say, I need a candy bar right now, you might be angry, lonely, tired. Stop, think, really, really try to ascertain whether you are hungry, angry, lonely, tired. Also, what I find is there's no commitment or consistency on so many people's lives. It's like, I'm good for a couple days, boom, I'm bad. I'm good for a couple days, boom, I'm bad. If you ascertain in your mind what you want out of life, somebody said to me today, you know, I'm worried about this one person in my life because, you know, she's really overweight. Is the waiting list too big? I said, bring people here. If there's someone you're worried about, have them call me. Also, keep tempting food and drink out of your house. I'm amazed when people eat all these cookies. I say, where are they coming from? And these are people who live alone. Where do they come from? They have to get there somehow. How exercise will make you happier. When you're having a bad day and you reach for exercise instead of the chips, you do feel happier. Your endorphins start going. You start moving. Just remember that moving can be a solution to something that you have in the past always reached for food. A nice recipe here for low fat, low sodium chicken casserole. I fall asleep at least once a week doing your food logs. Every once in a while, like Joanne's. Joanne's will have the most amazing things on it because she tries this, she tries that. You really do mix it up, Joanne, and I'm proud of you. Other people, not so much. Thank you, Bob. Thank you. Pray It Off right on schedule. You can turn it off and then we'll turn it